This is the OTB Television Network, a service of Capital District Off-Track Betting.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to this week's edition of Horses and Courses. 17 races to bring you, including a very big day of racing on Saturday at both Tampa Bay Downs and, of course, out at Santita, where they ran the $1 million big cap. We'll get to that later on in the program. We're going to start down at Tampa Bay Downs, kicking it off, the Challenger.
Now he's straightened up. And they're off. Outlash is away alertly, with Ghost Hunter now moving up, and Breaking Lucky away with the top flight. The late running neck and neck is the last horse away as they make the charge to the clubhouse turn. Outlash, the gray colt, racing well out from the inner rail and has the lead. Breaking Lucky moves up on the outside, now a bit closer to be second. Down along the inner rail, that's Amy's Holiday, now racing along third. This boy Sharp is right there in the mix from the outside. Adirondack King, a very close up sixth, three lengths farther back to neck and neck. A compact field as they turn up the backstretch, and Outlash continues to race extremely wide down the backstretch, but he has the lead by two. Ghost Hunter is right there from between horses second. This boy's Sharp racing along third. Amy's Holiday also there in the mix fourth. Length and a half farther back, Adrianic King, and it's a log jam up front as they leave the half-mile marker and circle the far turn. Outlash now drops back over and still commands the lead three parts of a length. Amy's Holiday is there toward the rail second. Breaking Lucky is all in, racing third. From the outside, Adrianic King is putting in a run and moving up very smartly. Four lengths farther back, here comes the late running neck and neck from nowhere and now moving to challenge as they race past the quarter-mile pole. Outlash has given way toward the rail to Adrianic King on the outside, and neck continues to sweep up on the outside. Now to challenges, they're into the stretch. Adrianic King is the leader. He'll have to hold up neck and neck down the center of the racetrack, and here's Breaking Lucky gaining. He alters course to the inside, and he's charging late down to the wire. Adrianic King neck and neck on the outside, neck and neck. Adrianic King. Adrianic King will take it over neck and neck with Breaking Lucky third, and it looks like Amy's Holiday might have got up for fourth.
Hard to imagine from a historical standpoint, ladies and gentlemen, 30 years and 2 months ago, the Challenger disaster. But Adirondack King wins by half a length. Javier Castellano in town for the Tampa Bay Derby later on. An 11-1 shot for John Service and Javier Castellano, an offspring of Lawyer Ron out of the Mare Jostle Saratoga lineage right there, folks. Adirondack King returns $25.20. Neck and neck finishes second. Breaking Lucky finishes third at 16-1. The 3-2 favorite, Outlash, finishes fifth. On to the turf, ladies and gentlemen, for the not the grade two, but the grade three Florida Oaks.
And they're off and running in the 33rd edition of the grade two Florida Oaks. Ava's Kitten is away alertly, and there goes locally based Masami. Moving up now to challenge, Conquest Bebop emerges now with the early lead. Toward the rail is Enjoy Yourself, and already far, far back in the early going is the late running Bonita. Under the wire for the first time from the outside, Valuable Charmer gets over to the two path and moves up and has the lead. Conquest Bebop racing along second. Eva's Kitten settles into stride nicely with a ground saving trip, now third. Up on the outside, Gamble's Ghost is alongside now to be fourth. A length farther back, Silver Magnolia is now racing along fifth. Locally based Enjoy Yourself coming off the maiden victory is sixth. 2.5 lengths farther back. From the outside, Miscellany. Back to the inside, that's Family Meeting. Then it's four lengths farther back to Gamble's Ghost. Gamble's Ghost will spot him about 8 lengths up the backstretch. To the inside, Bassani Piccoli. Then it's 2.5 lengths farther back, Descender. Then it's 4 lengths farther back to the trailer, Bonita. As they leave the half-mile marker and now swing around the far turn, Valuable Charmer at 90-1 has the lead but has been hard used to get there. Conquest Bebop in hand there toward the rail, racing along second. A length and a half farther back, That's Bassani and Bacoli. Now moving up now to challenge third. Up on the outside. Enjoy yourself now. Putting it around fourth and Avis Kitten. And now it's absolutely wide open as they turn for home and sprint to the wire. Toward the rail is Conquest. Bebop now with the lead and moving up on the outside. Bassani Bacoli and way out on the outside. Gaining ground. Fastest of all is Bassani Bacoli. And from between horses, enjoy yourself. An absolutely blanket finish in the Florida Oaks.
And for those who like to speak Italian, that's Kiss Me Baby or Bashimi Piccola scoring the victory by half a length with Julian Leperu in the saddle at nearly 15-1. Brian Lynch sends out the runner for Amarin Stable. They return $31 for the victory. Enjoy Yourself finishes second. Family Meeting finishes third. The first of our many upsets this weekend on Horses and Courses. Continuing on the turf, Fillies and Mares in the Grade 2 Hillsboro.
They're off and running in the 1 mile and 1/8 Grade 2 Hillsboro. Up on the outside, Button Down breaks for the lead with Royal Jewelry, and down along the inner rail quickly goes Isabella Songs. Isabella Songs now moves up and takes command, and the last horse away, Rene de Batteria, as they bend through the stretch. For the first time, Isabella Songs is suddenly about 7 or 8 lengths in front. Lori Lori racing along second. Teppan, the champion race mare, draws alongside. Settles into stride nicely in the two-path. Racing along third. Speed Seeker with a ground-saving trip toward the rail now fourth. Beru Duchamp is right there from between horses now fifth. Danza Cavallo on the outside sixth. Button Brown is now shuffled back to seventh. Then we go back to Ball Dancing eighth. The gap of three. Royal Jewelry racing along ninth. And Renea de Batteria is the trailer, and as they turn up the backstretch, I'll have to drop my binoculars to see how far she's in front. Isabella Sings, it's your guess how many lengths it is. Off by herself. Royal Laurie is toward the rail second. From the outside, Teppan is alongside her, racing along third. Then it's 4 lengths farther back. Beru Deschamps is down along the inner rail now fourth. As they swing around the far turn, Isabella Sings is still on a long lead, but now Teppan gets the wake-up call, and now moving up after the leader second. Lovely Lorie is there toward the rail third, but as they turn for home, Isabella Sings is still on a long, long lead. Up on the outside, Teppan is now set down for the drive, but the champion race mare has 5 lengths to make up, and she's gobbling up ground. Inside the final eighth of a mile, Isabella Sings, and here she comes. Teppan, she drops her head and is mowing him down. Teppan on the outside, and she'll get up and remain the champion she is by 3 parts of a length. Isabella Songs in a very game effort for second, and the running time on the board, 146.26.
And having gone faster now than anyone has gone, 1 1/8 on the turf at Tampa Bay Downs, a brilliant performance by both the winner and the runner-up, and there was only one other horse who was single-digit odds, but it's Teppan, the champ, who just keeps on keeping on. She runs down the loose leader, and Rich Grunder, I thought one part was funny where he said, I have to put the binocular down. The chart says that a half a mile into the race, Isabella Sings was 18 lengths in front. But at the end of the day, Teppan, for Mark Cassie, she sets a new low mutual, returning $2.80, lowering the inaugural Pleasant Temper, who returns $3.40 for the second year in a row. They ran the Hillsboro on the undercard of the Tampa Bay Derby, and the champ is brilliant once again. Isabella Sings, Johnny V did the best he can, and at 90-1, Lovely Lori finishes third. And annually, the premier race at Tampa Bay Downs, 3-year-olds in the Grade 2 Tampa Bay Derby.
And they're off. Away and running to a perfect start. Outwork wins the break. Economic Model now moves up. Riker is right there joining the fray. From the outside, Awesome Banner will take the worst of it and go to the turn 5 wide. As expected, the favorite, Brody's Cause. Lannery drops over to the rail and he'll spot him about 10 links as they circle the clubhouse turn. Outwork now going to the lead and has it by a length and a half. Riker is right there racing second. From the outside, Destin, the Sam Davis winner. He's in a perfect spot now, racing along third, a length clear of Economic Model down along the inner rail, now racing along fourth. Awesome Banner carrying the Jackster Better Cutters on the outside is fifth. Then we go back to Longshot Star Hill, sixth. 3.5 links farther back, Rafting, racing along seventh. Then it's 3 links farther back to Taylor Saval, and still the trailer is Brody's Cause, but he's only about 10 lengths off the pace setters as they leave the half-mile marker and circle the far turn. Outwork, he's going on with it, and he'll try to take them start to finish. Riker is second. Destin in the three-path. He's poised and ready to pounce now third. 3 lengths farther back to Star Hill, racing along fourth. Awesome Bander is under an all-out ride, racing along fifth. Rafting is now underway, racing along sixth as they approach the quarter-mile pole. It's still Outwork, and now he's being shoved on. Destin and Castellano, they'll take first run at the leader as they turn for home, 3/16 of a mile to run. Brody's Cause still has about 12 lengths to make up. Lannery swings into the outside, but he's still far back, a furlong to run. These two will dispute it. Destin on the outside, Outwork is there toward the game, and they're locked in battle down to the wire. It's Destin on the outside. He's going to better the two. Destin, Outwork, very gamely for second. 5 lengths farther back, Star Hill third. Rafting was fourth. Brody's Cause off the board as the favorite. Running time on the board, 142.82 in the Tampa Bay Derby.
Destin, Todd Pletcher, Javier Castellano, they set a new track record by 1/100th of a second, eclipsing Bold Start's record from 6 years ago. Destin returns $9.20, the offspring of Giants Causeway. Outwork finishes second. Star Hill finishes third. The 2-1 favorite, Brody's Cause, making the seasonal debut, finishes seventh. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, stakes action from Gulfstream Park, Laurel and Turfway.
No matter where in the world you are, the excitement of wagering on horse racing is just a click away. CapitalOTB.com offers live streaming, past performances, race replays, our virtual tote board, analysis and selections from professional handicappers, and a simple, safe, and secure wagering platform. And best of all, you get track prices. Going on now, it's Bet 50, Get 50. Simply open a Capital Bets account, bet $50, and get $50 cash back. CapitalOTB.com. Log on today.
Funding your Capital OTB bet account is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, easy money. Clearly the fastest and easiest method of depositing funds into your account. Make deposits or withdrawals in just minutes. 2, Green Dot Money Pack. Gives you instant access to your funds. Green Dot Money Packs are available at thousands of retailers nationwide. And 3, MasterCard Visa. Simply click on the link from the funding page, enter your account information, and fund your account. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turn your attention to Gulfstream Park for a pair of 5-furlong turf sprints. Up first, the boys in the Silks Run.
They're off in the Silks Run. Do the Roar goes out to take the early lead. Grand Billy on the outside. Power Alert is right there in between horses. And then it's Dr. J-Dub on the inside as they run up the backstretch. Then Simon Barr Sinister and Hothersall, followed by Amelia's Wild Ride, who's down at the rail inside of Bold Thunder. Last of them all is Star Contender. And now they're racing for the far turn. And it's Power Alert who takes the lead. Power Alert in front from Do the Roar. Dr. J-Dub sent along between those two after a 21-1 opening quarter mile. Amelia's Wild Ride is down on the inside, 2.5 lengths off of Power Alert as they come to the top of the stretch. Power Alert off the turn in front. Amelia's Wild Ride with a perfect trip slips through on the inside and now angles out to try to come and get Power Alert. These two down to the last 16th together. Power Alert and Amelia's Wild Ride. Power Alert still going strong. Amelia's Wild Ride can't get there. Power Alert has won. Amelia's Wild Ride was second. And then a photo between Hothersall and Do the Roar, followed by Star Contender.
Brian Lynch sends out the winner with Luis Saez, the second choice in the wagering at 3-2. Power Alert scores by 3/4 of a length. Look at the final running time at 54.83, ladies and gentlemen. That'll be of note in just a moment. The 6-5 favorite, the familiar Amelia's Wild Ride, finishes second. Do the Roar finishes third. A couple races later, time for the fillies and mares in the Captiva Island.
They're off on the Captiva Island. Granny's drink hopped in the air at the break. Jewel of a Cat comes out running well. Katie's Kiss has got speed. Maggie's Freudian Slip now on the outside, up and after the front. And they're being followed by Miss Matzo Ball, wrapped to the outside. On the far outside, Granny's Drink, and then Susie's a Cowgirl, and the trailer is Forest Funds as the field races for the far turn. Maggie's Freudian Slip has taken the lead here. Opens up a length and a half from Katie's Kiss and Jewel of a Cat through a 21 flat opening quarter mile. Now these two move up right alongside, and there's three across the track, and Maggie's Freudian Slip is not handling the turn at all. Jewel of a Cat had to go wide, so did Granny's Drink, and that makes things a lot better for Katie's Kiss, who's off the turn two lengths out in front. Katie's Kiss to catch Jewel of a Cat on the outside, and Miss Matzo Ball trying to close in. Katie's Kiss, here comes Miss Matzo Ball. Miss Matzo Ball on the outside of Katie's Kiss gets up to win the Captiva Island. And then came Jewel of a Cat, Forest Funds, and Susie's a Cowgirl.
Miss Matzo Ball with Edgar Zayas in the saddle scores the upset victory as the fourth choice in the wagering. Roy Lehrman sends out the winner, returning $20.20. You see the final running time at 54.62. 21 one-hundredths of a second faster than the boys. Katie's Kiss finishes second. Jewel the Cat, the 6-5 favorite, finishes third. Turning our attention to Laurel Park for a couple of stakes races on Saturday afternoon. Up first, the boys in the private terms.
And they're off in the private terms. Whiskey Tree Flash, McCall, Marengo Row, the inside three away in good order. Abiding Star is trying to make the lead from the far outside. Is caught wide, but now gone to a narrow lead. Let Me Go first to the back of the pack with Charmed Victory, who trails six lengths from first to last. And Abiding Star setting sail up front now. Abiding Star about a length and a quarter in front from Whiskey Tree is taken back in second spot. Length and a half, and Marengo Road is just in third. And Let Me Go first, followed by Flash McCall, who's five lengths off that pacemaker in Charmed Victory, the outside. Still a tight pack after a 24-4 opening quarter mile. With 5 1/2 furlongs left to go, Abiding Star slows it right down up front a length and a quarter for Whiskey Tree second. Marengo Road is just third from Let Me Go first. And then Charmed Victory and Flash McCall's at the rail, only five lengths from that front runner. Abiding Star, who went an easy 49 3/2 mile, heads on for the far turn run with a lead by almost two lengths. Abiding Star from Whiskey Tree. Marengo Road off the inside, and Let Me Go first up far outside. Flash McCall is at the rail, asks for a little more run, and Charmed Victory really has to pick it up now with three furlongs left to go. Abiding Star and Evian Toledo, then all are running up front from Whiskey Tree. They've got the lead by a length at the quarter pole on the top of the stretch. Marengo Road and Flash McCall followed by Charmed Victory. Let Me Go first last. They make the turn for home. Abiding Star shows the way well off that rail, kicks away by three. The inside is Flash McCall, is trying to drive hard, but it's Abiding Star. Abiding Star slowed down that pace up front to the final furlong with a three-length lead on Flash McCall, then Whiskey Tree, and they're close to home in the private term stakes. It's Abiding Star holding sway. Abiding Star by two lengths. Flash McCall digging hard for second, and then Whiskey Tree and Marengo Road. Charmed Victory, Let Me Go first.
Abiding Star, the offspring of Uncle Mo, scores the huge upset victory, the longest shot on the board. Abiding Star returns $39.40. Flash McCall finishes second. The second longest shot on the board, Whiskey Tree, finishes third. The trifecta, ladies and gentlemen, in a six-horse field, I kid you not, $1,784. The 8-5 shot, Marengo Row, finishes fourth, and the 3-2 favorite, Charmed Victory, finishes fifth in the private terms. And now time for three-year-old fillies in the Caesar's Wish.
Lined up. Off in the Caesar's Wish. Good start for Sophia's Song and Prognosis and Claire's Dowry from the outside gate. Disco Rose, Great Soul from the inside, just two lengths off that lead now and pushing forward. And so they're 4-5 back, and now lagging way behind is In the Navy Now, has actually dropped out of it now, some 13 off that pacemaker. The favorite, Sophia's Song, is in control here in the Caesar's Wish.
Sophia's Song sails along with Prognosis a length off of her in second spot. Then Claire's Dowry and Great Soul at the Rail and Disco Rosen in the Navy Now, 24-2. Very easy pace out there for Sophia's Song and Victor Carrasco. They've got a free run up front with a 2-length lead heading into the Laurel Fire Turn with 4.5 furlongs to go to the second wire. Sophia's Song 2 lengths in front from Great Soul and Prognosis. And then it's Claire's Dowry, Disco Rose, now fourth. Claire's Dowry back in fifth in the Navy Now, still the laggard with 3.5 furlongs to go to the second wire run. No pressure at all for Sophia's Song up front in a 48 second half mile. Leads by 3 lengths from Great Soul is driven second, and Disco Rose comes off the inside to try to make a bid into the second spot now with a quarter of a mile left to go. Is 6-1, 12 3/5 of a second. Sophia's Song and Victor Carrasco took a peek there, left and now right-handed, is Sophia's Song in front with a 4-length lead. Great Soul second, then Disco Rose to the outside in the Navy Now, lagged well behind early, has now moved into third, a 16th to go, and Sophia's Song ridden out and rolling home in the Caesar's Wish. From Great Soul in the Navy Now, followed by Disco Rose.
Todd Pletcher winning everywhere. Sophia's Song goes to the front, makes every poll a winning one under Victor Carrasco. The 3-10 favorite returns $2.60, followed by Great Soul and In the Navy Now finishes third in this year's Caesar's Wish. Turning our attention to Turfway Park for the John Battaglia Memorial.
And they're off. From the inside, Oz broke well with Blue Wings and Triple Creek. Those three together. Brary up from the extreme outside between horses. What a Wonderful World into the first turn. And Blue Wings comes away with the lead, has it by a length and a half. Triple Creek second ahead. Then up from the outside into third, that's Swagger Jagger. Now center of the track, Oz moves up. Also from the extreme outside, Brary. Then from between horses, What a Wonderful World, followed by Torrentis. It's a length back. Sawyer's Mickey had to check up there along the rail. Then a gap of three to Riding in the Wind. Moving through from the rail, Bandar. The trailers are Strike Up the Band and Surgical Strike. They got the half and 48 continuing down the back stretch. Down along the inside, Blue Wing still leads it over. Oz in second. Brary on the outside third. Swagger Jagger fourth ahead. Wonderful, What a Wonderful World gains ground now from fifth. Then through from the inside into sixth, that's Triple Creek. Center of the track, Sawyer's Mickey. Gap of three. Late run, here comes Surgical Strike, who now moves up from the outside as they move for the stretch. Oz, Blue Wings, What a Wonderful World, Sawyer's Mickey. Surgical Strike goes extremely wide. They're very well bunched into the stretch in the center of the track. What a Wonderful World. Here comes Surgical Strike up on the outside, and Surgical Strike gets the lead from What a Wonderful World. Late run from Sawyer's Mickey. It's Surgical Strike. Surgical Strike and Orlando Mojica win the Battaglia by two. Finishing second was What a Wonderful World, and Sawyer's Mickey, late run from Strike Up the Band.
Annually, the local prep for the Spiral Stakes, Surgical Strike, second choice in the wagering, sent out by Ben Colbrook, scores the victory. Orlando Mojica in the saddle, Surgical Strike, returns $8.20. What a Wonderful World. Favorite at 5-2 finishes second. Sawyer's Mickey finishes third. We'll take a quick break. When we come back, Saturday Stakes action from Santa Anita.
There's nothing like the thrill and excitement of horse racing. And now, the new home for all the best racing and all the top tracks is OTB-TV, Digital Channel 8.2, delivering each day the best racing across the country and around the world. Whether it's Saratoga or Belmont here in New York, Florida's Gulfstream Park, or California's Del Mar and Santa Anita racecourses, no other network brings you the grandeur of horse racing like OTB-TV on Digital Channel 8.2.
24 hours a day, 7 days a week, OTB-TV is the Capital Region's choice for the most comprehensive and informative coverage of thoroughbred and harness racing. OTB-TV is the only area network delivering a steady viewership, reaching more than 540,000 households throughout the broadcast day and into the evening. Capital OTB's digital presence also plays a tremendous part in getting your message in front of potential customers. With more and more wagering moving to online, CapitalOTB.com can put your message in front of thousands of potential customers 24 hours a day. And with the addition of our new mobile app, new customers will see your message on all their digital devices. To see how affordably you can reach thousands of new customers, contact Capital OTB's Sales and Marketing Department today. You're
unbelievable. Funding your Capital OTB bet account is as easy as 1, 2, 3. 1, easy money. Clearly the fastest and easiest method of depositing funds into your account. Make deposits or withdrawals in just minutes. 2, Green Dot Money Pack. Gives you instant access to your funds. Green Dot Money Packs are available at thousands of retailers nationwide. And 3, MasterCard Visa. Simply click on the link from the funding page, enter your account information, and fund your account. CapitalOTBBet.com. Log on today.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to the great race place on Saturday afternoon annually, their biggest day of the spring, the winter spring meet. Up first, the Grade 1 Frank Kilroe Mile.
And they're off in the Frankie Kilroe Mile. Smooth beginning and not much pace on through the opening furlong. Came away in good order as they line up right across the course. Now Kenji Storm picks up the running on the outside of What a View. At the rail, Bala Bali. Midnight Storm understandably has to go wide into the first turn, and Bolo will settle as the trailer. Around the first turn, and What a View leads by a length. Maybe a bit of a surprise through this opening quarter mile, with Kenji Storm flanked on him in second. Then it's Midnight Storm. Settles down at the rail fourth. Bala Bali under a nice hold in between those two, and Bolo is the trailer. Down the backstretch they go, and it's What a View, three quarters of a length. Kenji Storm is in second. Midnight Storm, side by side, past the half-mile pole. Bala Bali is still in between those two, and Bolo yet to do his best running at the back. They have three-eighths of a mile to go, and it is still What a View showing the way. The lead up to a length and a half on Kenji Storm. Bala Bali is firing a nice shot along the inside. Midnight Storm outside of him. Did not go on. And Bolo in the blue on the far outside. But they all have work to do to catch What a View, who's still cruising at the top of the stretch. He's in front by four. Bolo in the center of the course, and Bala Bali are trying their best with Midnight Storm. They're in the final furlong, and it's still What a View. The Cowbred turning in a spectacular performance on the front end. He made short work of the competition in the Frankie Kilroe Mile. What a View strolls. Very close photo for second between Bala Bali and Bolo, then Midnight Storm.
And over a turf course listed as good, What a View scores the victory. Kent DeSormo puts the winner on the front end, makes every call, returns $14 even. The 2-1 favorite from last to seven, Bolo finishes second. And Bala Bali, second choice in the wagering, also at 2-1, finishes third. Now time for three-year-olds in the local prep for the Santa Anita Derby, the San Felipe.
And they're off in the San Felipe. Dancing Candy began very smoothly. Uncle Lino will get the lead. Those two stride for stride, and I Will Score as a close-up third. They're followed by More Spirit on the inside of Smoky Image, and absolutely no early speed from Exaggerator, who's taken over to the rail. Around the first turn, and Dancing Candy, out where he likes to be, opens up a length and a half on Uncle Lino in second. I Will Score between them, and Smoky Image is three wide, three lengths off the pace. More Spirit has settled down in a very good spot. He's about five or six lengths off the pace, and four clear of Exaggerator. They have five-eighths of a mile to go in the San Felipe, and it's Mike Smith dictating the terms on Dancing Candy. He's in front by 2.5 lengths. Uncle Lino is asked to cut into the margin. I Will Score and Smoky Image, those three in a line for second past the half-mile pole. More Spirit is well off the rail as Exaggerator starts to come into the race now, and Exaggerator just went by More Spirit heading to the 3/8 pole, where Dancing Candy has been uncontested throughout. He's in front by 2.5 lengths. Uncle Lino is now under pressure. Exaggerator has made a bold move. He's all the way up to take second now in between horses, coming after Dancing Candy. Just behind them comes More Spirit with five to make up. Then I Will Score and Smoky Image. Dancing Candy turns for home, and he's trying to fend off Exaggerator, who's two lengths behind second. More Spirit is fully extended. Dancing Candy's the real deal. He's in front by two lengths, coming to the 16th pole, and he takes a major step forward this afternoon. Dancing Candy, wire to wire in the San Felipe Stakes, and there's plenty left in the tank. More Spirit closed well for second, Exaggerator third, Uncle Lino was fourth.
On a racetrack that might have been helping, Hall of Famer Mike Smith puts the offspring of Twirling Candy on the front end, and Dancing Candy makes every call, ladies and gentlemen, returning $13 even for the upset for the good guys. The 8-5 favorite, More Spirit, who might have been up against it on the racetrack, finishes second, and trying to come from last, Exaggerate, the 2-1 second choice, finishes third. And with the 50 points earned by the winner, history tells us that that should guarantee them a spot in the Kentucky Derby. Now sprinters going 7/8 in the San Carlos.
And they're off. Calculator was off just a step slowly. Wild Dude, but there goes San Onofre, intent on going out to set the pace. Mystery Train will keep him company and takes the lead now through the opening furlong. It's Mystery Train opening up two lengths. Outside Nashville is now in second, and San Onofre in third. They're followed by Cautious Giant, taken in hand fourth. He's about 3.5 lengths off the early tempo. Then Coastline, Calculator is making an early bid. Wild Dude has to keep pace with 8 to make up. And no surprise to see Kobe's back at the back of the pack, heading past the half-mile pole. The leader is Mystery Train into the far turn by 1.5 lengths to outside Nashville. San Onofre is in third. Cautious Giant moves up outside of him and claims third. Then Calculator in fifth. He's 4 lengths off the lead. Coastline is just inside of him. It's another 4. Kobe's back is underway, starting to commence a bid. And that leaves last year's winner, Wild Dude, as the trailer. They pass the quarter pole and turn for home. Outside Nashville, the leader, Calculator. Kobe's back kicking into high gear. Coastline firing a big shot, and Cautious Giant is in the thick of it. A driving finish. Coastline comes through to take the lead. Has to hold off Kobe's back on the outside, and Calculator in between them. But Kobe's back is erupting in the center of the track. And Kobe's back indeed, winning the San Carlos. Coastline second. Calculator completes the gray trifecta, and Cautious Giant finish fourth.
Kobe's back, who just enjoys Santa Anita, ladies and gentlemen, scores another victory from last to first. The 2-1 favorite, the offspring of Flatter, sent out by Peter Yurton, ridden by Gary Stevens. They win by 1.25 lengths, returning $6 even. Coastline at 13-1 finishes second. And Calculator, the 5-2 second choice, finishes third. Up next, the Grade 1, $1 million, 1.25 lengths, big cap.
And they're off in the big cap. It was a smooth beginning, and General A-Rod and Melatonin are the first two out. Donworth came away in good order, and so did the favorite FNX, who's up to take third. Cyrus Alexander is fifth as they pass the stands the first time. Then it's Hard Aces on the inside of Imperative. Point Piper is second to last, and Class Leader guided over to the rail. There's a mile left to run. It's Melatonin stride for stride with General A-Rod. Donworth eager just behind them. He's tugging very hard behind the top two. FNX has settled into a nice stride in the clear. 3 wide now, 2 lengths off the pace. Cyrus Alexander completes the first 5. It's a gap of 5 then to Imperative outside Hard Aces. Another 4 to Point Piper, and Class Leader is at the back. The pace is honest as they make their way onto the backstretch. Melatonin shows the way, 3/4 length. General A-Rod, and a perfect trip for FNX in third. They're followed by Donworth, who's taken in hand fourth, 4 lengths off the lead. He's got some run in him. He's starting to tug forward once again, needs somewhere to go. Outside of him comes Cyrus Alexander. Imperative, yet to do his best running with 7 to make up. Hard Aces, Class Leader on the inside of Point Piper. 3/8 of a mile to go. Melatonin, General A-Rod puts the pressure on. Donworth is just loaded, still nowhere to go. He almost clipped heels. In the meantime, FNX makes his move on the outside. Melatonin, FNX on the outside. General A-Rod the first to come under pressure. Imperative Extreme outside. Hard Aces is trying to now get his way through traffic. Down at the rail, Donworth, Point Piper, and Class Leader. They're at the top of the stretch. And Melatonin is running the race of his life. He leads by two now. Donworth gets clear sailing on the inside of FNX. Imperative inside of him. Hard Aces. They're in the final furlong. And it is Melatonin. And he's putting them to sleep in the big cap under Joe Talamo. Melatonin airs. He wins by five. Hard Aces second. Third to FNX. And then came Imperative.
Melatonin, the offspring of Kodiak Cowboy, I kid you not, sent out by David Hoffmans, gets put on the front end by Joe Talamo. They never look back. They win by a comfortable 4-plus lengths at 16-1. Melatonin returns $34.60. And the horse that I like, that 22-1 Hard Aces, finishes a distant second. And FNX, making the first start since winning the Clark, the 7-5 favorite, finishes third in this year's big cap. We take our final break when we come back. Sunday stakes action from Santa Anita and the Big A.
Now get all the racing information you need right on your mobile device with Capital OTB's new mobile app. Wager anytime, anywhere, right from your smartphone or tablet. Get up-to-the-minute scratches and race results. Watch our morning TV shows. Check out the Handicapper's Report. Find a branch or easy bet location and be up-to-date on all our latest promotions. It's everything you need to watch, wager, and win right at your fingertips. The new Capital OTB mobile app. Download it free from the iTunes Store or Google Play.
There's nothing like the thrill and excitement of horse racing. And now, the new home for all the best racing and all the top tracks is OTB-TV on Time Warner Cable Channel 1250, delivering each day the best racing across the country and around the world, whether it's Saratoga or Belmont here in New York, Florida's Gulfstream Park, or California's Del Mar and Santa Anita race courses. No other network brings you the grandeur of horse racing like OTB-TV on Time Warner Cable Channel 1250.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Turning our attention to Sunday at Santa Anita, a couple of turf races up first. Three-year-olds in the Pasadena.
And they're off. Dressed in Hermes broke out very alertly. It's the ice matching strides, Arcature, and Sorry About Nothing. Now these three go on with it as Dressed in Hermes is taken in hand fourth. Markula is racing on the outside, and Mr. Rory is in between rivals. So It's the Ice will set the pace. Pretty much uncontested. Sorry About Nothing is chasing from second, and Dressed in Hermes moves through on the inside third. They're followed by Arcature in fourth. Mr. Rory is fifth and five lengths off the lead, and Markula is outside of him. They're onto the backstretch, and It's the Ice. Comfortable up top while leading by a length. A nice tracking trip for Sorry About Nothing in second, and Dressed in Hermes at the rail in third. They're followed by Arcature fourth, 3.5 lengths off the tempo, Mr. Rory and Markula between them. Half mile left to go in the Pasadena, and It's the Ice has been there every step of the way, maintains the lead 3/4 of a length. Sorry About Nothing going to put a little more pressure on him in second. Dressed in Hermes has been guided into the clear, blue cap on the outside, Mr. Rory on the fence, Markula between them, and Arcature now last. It's the Ice sneaking away, coming to the quarter pole. It's nearly a 2-length lead. Sorry About Nothing just felt the whip. Dressed in Hermes on the outside has to pick it up. Mr. Rory, Arcature trying to rally from behind. Top of the stretch, It's the Ice floats out. He maintains a lead. Dressed in Hermes chasing with determination in the center of the course. These two squaring off, and now the leader getting weary as Dressed in Hermes right up alongside, still under a hand ride. Mike Smith shows him the whip, and now he puts his head in front past the 16th pole. Dressed in Hermes will win it going away. Second to It's the Ice. Photo for third. Sorry About Nothing in front of Arcature.
And over at turf course, still listed as good, Mike Smith scores the victory on the 2-5 favorite, Dressed in Hermes. They win by 3/4 of a length, returning $2.80. It's the Ice finishes second, and at 24-1, Sorry About Nothing finishes third. Now hold on tight, ladies and gentlemen. Over at turf course, listed as good, we have the 1.5-mile San Luis Rey.
And they're off in the San Luis Rey. It's a quick beginning for Havana Bell, who goes straight to the front, joined by Southern Freedom at the rail, and in between them, Going Somewhere is prominent as well. High Ball in the pink colors on the extreme outside is in Ford. Then it's Gaga Ah racing on the outside of Powerfoot, who's 6 lengths off the lead. Energia Fribi is next, followed by Generosidad. It's then a gap of 5 to the 2 trailers, and they are Quick Casablanca and Big John B, as usual, with no early speed as they get ready to cross the dirt for the first time. On the outside, it is Havana Bell and Southern Freedom in the white blinkers at the rail. Just in behind them comes High Ball in third, 2 lengths off this moderate tempo. Then comes Going Somewhere, settled in the fourth spot, eager to get going and guided a little bit off the rail. Gaga Ah is the gray in mid-pack, racing on the outside of Powerfoot. Then Energia Fribi, who's about a dozen lengths off the lead. Generosidad is 3 quarters behind her at the rail. Casablanca and Big John B is outside of that rival. Into the turn they go for the first time, and the leader at the rail is Southern Freedom. Up alongside is Havana Bell. Havana Bell goes on to lead by a length. In third comes High Ball, just tracking them, and a gap of about 5 to Going Somewhere in fourth. Gaga Ah is making progress. Powerfoot is asked to get going down at the rail. Then comes Energia Fribi on the outside of Generosidad, Big John B, and Quick Casablanca at the back. 9 lengths covers the field as they head to the half-mile pole. It's still Havana Bell carving out the fractions, pursued by Southern Freedom and High Ball 3 wide in third. Gaga Ah is in fourth. Powerfoot at the rail in fifth, about 5 lengths off the lead. Inside of that one comes Generosidad, who's actually in between horses, 5 lengths off them. Then Energia Fribi, who has 8 to make up. Quick Casablanca is looking for some racing room while commencing a bid. Big John B yet to do his best work and Going Somewhere. In the meantime, Havana Bell is trying to close the deal. She's in front 3 quarters of a length. Now Generosidad is making a bold bid and has room if good enough. And Generosidad is up to take the lead. Outside of her comes High Ball, who's running a big one. Gaga Ah is next. And then Energia Fribi. Final furlong. Generosidad in front 3 quarters of a length to High Ball. And it will be the distaffer, Generosidad and Tiago Pereira, to win the San Luis Rey. Quick Casablanca came flying for second. Energia Fribi was third. High Ball fourth.
Ladies and gentlemen, there were 5 horses at double-digit odds, and you're looking at 3 of them. The fourth one completed the superfecta, which for a dollar came back a little over $87,000. But the winner, ridden by Tiago Piara, the 7-year-old mare, the Uruguayan, scores the gigantic upset, the longest shot on the board, 10th choice. At 71-1, my notes don't cover every single running of the San Luis Rey, but they go back a long time. And the last time the 10th choice won it was 91. Pleasant Variety returned $61. This 10th choice returns $144.80, followed by the Chilean at 10-1, followed by the Brazilian at 3-1, ladies and gentlemen. A shocker in Sunday's San Luis Rey. The mare gets it done. All right, headed back east, ladies and gentlemen. Saturday afternoon, the Tom Fool.
And they're off. And they all came away to a good start. Waco, Dad's Caps, Stall Walking Dude, down towards the inside is Always Sunshine. And now moving up is Me Wanna Rose. So it's Dad's Caps and Me Wanna Rose right together. Waco on the outside in third. Spartiatus advances at the rail into fourth. Always Sunshine in fifth. Stall Walking Dude runs in sixth. On the extreme outside is Low Key's Vengeance in seventh. Then it's Angry Moon next in eighth. It's a break of 3 lengths back to Newbin Ridge. Then Alex the Terror and Salutos Amigos is at the back of the pack after an opening quarter in 22 1/5 seconds. Dad's Caps now makes the lead as the field hits the head of the stretch. Me Wanna Rose is on the outside in second. Then Stall Walking Dude, Always Sunshine down at the rail, followed by Low Key's Vengeance. Salutos Amigos is beginning to pick it up out in the middle of the track, and here he comes. It is Stall Walking Dude. Here comes Salutos Amigos. What a move here from last to first. He's going to win the Tom Fool Handicap once again. And it was an eye-popping performance by Salutos Amigos. Ran the 6 furlongs in 1 minute 10 seconds.
Saludos amigos, ladies and gentlemen. And scores the victory rather emphatically. Just a tremendous job by David Jacobson. The 7-5 favorite returns $4.80. Always Sunshine, the invader, at 9-1 finishes second. Stall Walking Dude finishes third with the first start of the year. Surprised the trifecta came back a healthy 4.43, ladies and gentlemen. Sunday afternoon, the stymie.
And the rough, Stormin' Monarco from the inside post. Our caravan, Made from Lucky, is right there. And Don't Bet with Bruno now advancing in between horses. Indicott runs in fifth. Turco Bravo is at the back. Down on the inside, it's Stormin' Monarco. And on the outside, it's Don't Bet with Bruno. So the two of them heads apart for the lead. Made from Lucky sets up down towards the inside and is running in third. Our caravan next in fourth. And then comes Indicott and Turco Bravo. Stormin' Monarco leads here by 3/4 of a length over Don't Bet with Bruno. Now Made from Lucky has come off the inside, is racing in third, 3 lengths from the front. And then it's Our Caravan and Indicott. Last year's winner Turco Bravo remains at the back. They're midway up the backstretch with Stormin' Monarco setting the pace and leading here by a half length. Don't Bet with Bruno in second, the quarter 23-2, and the half mile in 48 seconds. There goes Turco Bravo now, moving up down on the inside. Turco Bravo and Made from Lucky are heads apart, third and fourth. Indicott is fifth. Our Caravan is now the trailer. They start the run into the far turn. Stormin' Monarco down at the rail, holding on to a narrow lead over Don't Bet with Bruno. Made from Lucky on the outside in third, and then Turco Bravo, followed by Indicott and Our Caravan as they move for the quarter pole. Don't Bet with Bruno on the outside of Stormin' Monarco, and the two of them are right together. Then Turco Bravo and Made from Lucky on the outside. Indicott is fifth with a furlong to the finish. Don't Bet with Bruno, Stormin' Monarco, Turco Bravo looking to squeeze in between horses. Made from Lucky's on the outside. Here comes Turco Bravo. Turco Bravo looking to win the stymie once again, and he has done it at a huge price, 20-1. Don't Bet with Bruno a second, and Made from Lucky finished third.
The Chilean bred Turco Bravo scores the huge upset, ladies and gentlemen. Turco Bravo, the only horse over 6-1, the long shot of the board at 20-1 for Gary Contessa, Manny Franco, last to first, 42-40. The 8-5 favorite, Don't Bet with Bruno, finishes second. The 9-5 second choice, Made from Lucky, finishes third in the stymie. Well, that wraps up this thrilling edition of HNC, ladies and gentlemen. Enjoy your stakes action from around the country and join us next time for Horses and Courses.
You're watching OTB TV, a service of Capital Off-Track Betting.